to Positive Atheism English channel. Today I am going to present you the book on Thoughts of Periyar compiled by Dr. K. Veeramani. Second part of Religious Fanaticism. Religion just nurtures superstition. Human beings first started living in the forest like animals, each person looking after himself. Then they crossed that stage and started living affectionately in groups. Even at that stage, they felt the need for some principles. If people living in a certain area start an association for common benefit, they feel the need to frame certain rules for the management of that association. So too in the ancient days, when people started living together, they had to frame some rules or agree on certain principles for community life. Those principles have now come to be called religion. To prevent people from going against those principles, they framed certain rules of conduct. Probably because those who framed the rules and principles were either unwilling or not in a position to punish those who broke the rules, or for personal benefit, or for exploiting others, or because they felt that common people could be deceived only if the rules were association with God. They had to say that the rules are framed by God and those who broke the rules would be punished by God. If we examine on what basis these rules were framed, we will have to come to the conclusion that the spirit of the time, the climate, the brain power of the people, the stupidity of the majority, and the scheming nature of the few determined the rules. Further, when a particular principle does not suit a group of people belonging to a later age, or when it is found inconvenient by certain selfish people, a clever or a cunning person may try to change that principle. If the superstitious common people obstinately object to the change, those who want to have the change form another group and they either modify the old rules or add new ones. The result is considered a new religion. If two or more new religions arise, the blind followers of these religions claim that their own religion is superior to the others and thus religious feuds arise. Some wise elders have tried to avoid clashes and keep everybody contented by giving new interpretations to the old principles. Still, their attempts also have given rise to branch religions and have not helped people to understand the real significance of each of the principles originally evolved. Since this process of changing, modifying, or giving new interpretation have been going on, people have not understood the nature of the religions and their need. As a result, religion has come to be taken as a set of rituals. If we ask any person belonging to any religion what the basic principles of his religion are, he cannot give a satisfactory answer. He will give only the details about the rituals connected with his religion. This kind of ignorance about religion has led to some evils in society. Some people have exploited the ignorance of the masses for personal benefit. The so-called major religions of the world have not been beneficial to mankind in any way. They have only helped the priest, the government, and the right people to deceive or ill-treat the common people and benefit thereby. Further, we find that these religions have given rise to some evils in society. Similarly, religion perverts the intelligence of the common man. Everyone thinks that his religion has been given by God. He does not pause to think that people belonging to other religions also think that their respective religion have been given rise to by God. How can the same God start many religions which are different from one another? Nobody seems to think about this. The heads of religions and lovers of religions are all in the same position. From this alone, we can understand how far religion has obstructed the thinking power of people. Secondly, instead of uniting people, religion helps only to separate them from one another. Thirdly, religion makes man derive satisfaction from outward appearances and does not lay emphasis on character. It is in the nature of religion, however good it is, to force people to accept as truth something or some idea which we cannot scrutinize. If we blindly accept one idea because it is related to religion, we tend to accept many others in the same way. Further, religion trains us to give great importance to people like priests who act as intermediaries between us and God, and we accept even their unreasonable words as being more dependable than what we have learned from our experience or what our intellect finds as truth. Religion encourages people to believe that by spending money lavishly, they can get their sins pardoned and that they can go to heaven. Since it makes people believe that through prayer God's pardon can be obtained, they are tempted to indulge in evil actions, if thereby they can earn money. For lazy life, religions give great scope. It also makes people cowards. Because it discourages independent thought, people are not able to judge what is right and what is wrong in worldly affairs. It enables some coming people to benefit by the labor of others. Those who belong to the Saivite religion claim that the moment a little of the scared ash falls on their bodies, all their sins leave them and they become fit for heaven. Those who work as advocates of religion and those who give public discourses on the false Puranic consider themselves as Saivites simply because they apply ash to their foreheads. They also with other to take them to the Saivites. From this we can understand the nature of the Saivites and the Saivite religion. The Vaishnavite claims that if a person utters the Rama once, all his sins are washed out and that there is no God other than Rama. Similarly, one who claims to be a true Christian say that if a person firmly believes in Jesus, he will be free from all his sins and that pardons for sins can be got from Jesus alone. Following the same trend, a Muslim says the Quran is a compilation of God's utterances suitable for all countries and all periods, and if the last change is made in the Quran, the changed version will not apply to Islam. Thus, the people of Erie religion claims that their religion is the true religion and that it has been evolved by an incarnation of God or God's son or a messenger of God. Thank you.
Please download Samaram Multi-Channel app and watch your favorite channels from your mobile. App available on Google Play Store and subscribe to the channels. For more videos, please subscribe to this channel, Positive Atheism, and activate the bell icon.